In Hatha Yoga, do you work with the subtle physical or with the gross physical? In fact, in the proper Hatha Yoga, not basic asanas which we do and which people call Hatha Yoga, in the proper Hatha Yoga, you work with the physical and through the physical on the vital. And through the vital on the spiritual. Mental and spiritual. So the rationale is like this. The recognition is that the physical body plugs into the subtle body through the chakras and other centers. And since you are not conscious of your subtle body and you are conscious of the physical, well, by certain physical positions and exercises, you are first triggering and activating those centers. Second, by the pranayama exercises, following a certain sequence and pattern, you are infusing into the physical body an enormous amount of the universal vital energy, through which it's as if your subtle body begins to grow more dense, more conscious. And as a first step, you become conscious of your subtle physical body, and through that eventually the vital body, and through it even the mental body. But it's the combination of activation of the centers and the infusion of life force, which is the link between the physical and the vital. Through that, it's as if your consciousness is liberated from its narrower physical identification. And you grow conscious of your subtle until, again, the focus there is activation of the kundalini and its awakening through the chakras, through which you open out to the cosmic consciousness eventually. And the result is a spiritual awakening or liberation. But the primary activation is through the physical process of asanas and pranayama. Yes. Yes, so in fact, that whole process in the Hatha Yoga tradition itself is described in a very general way. Ultimately leaving the higher part of the development to the influence of the teacher. And that's why the advanced practices of Hatha Yoga are not done alone. They are done by somebody who's already attained that, who then can assist or navigate the awakening of the kundalini in you, which is bottom up in the method used in Hatha Yoga. In practice, though, you will see in the later traditions, and Hatha Yoga you can see largely formulated in the Natha tradition. In the later parts of the Natha tradition, there are also variations which involve up to down descent and concentration above head first and subsequently downward, which is not taught in the conventional Hatha Yoga traditions and so on. So there are variations even within that, many schools of thought and knowledge. Much of this is still hidden or some of it lost, because not many can get to that point. Because it's a very slow and laborious process. And that's where Raja Yoga comes in, which uses not primarily physical methods, but direct psychological methods to achieve the same result of awakening of chakras. And there the top down is much more strong in the practice. And there elements of the asanas and pranayama are taken up. Those elements are all that we are taught normally today when you go to a yoga school which teaches asanas, pranayama, only that much. But if you take only that, that's the basis for Raja Yoga. The real practice of Raja Yoga is in the deeper meditation, which is not taught. Because again, you need somebody who has that capacity himself. And so the spiritual dimension, both in the Hatha and Raja Yoga tradition, largely is not there in the public teaching. But you understand the principle, and in both the method uses different starting point, but for the awakening of the centers and the kundalini to liberate the consciousness. In the integral yoga, we use a different approach where elements of the Raja Yoga are obviously closer to this, but relying on none of the external means, using them as needed but not dependent on them. The first thing done is purifying your consciousness and putting it in relation with the divine Shakti, which is above the head. And increasingly as your consciousness, including your mind awareness as it is, begins to open out and give itself to her, there is a descent from above of her action. And that she is the Mahakundalini, the cosmic Kundalini. She descending from above works then to further complete the purification open the chakra top down and partially, preparing a full link all the way down in a first level of purification, awakening a partial awakening of the individual kundalini bottom up, and then another descent and another ascent through a series of descents and ascents in which you may not notice anything until the full awakening gradually takes place. No shock, no danger, no destabilization as can happen in the normal Hatha Yoga or Raja Yoga processes. And it is all led by the action of the liberated divine consciousness, which is the prime driver. Your role is basically to open yourself to it and assist and participate in the process. So it is much more rapid. It can achieve in a few years what Hatha Yoga might take many decades, but much safer and much more complete. Also, inherently in the process, because that's the goal of the integral yoga, every part of our consciousness is taken up. Unlike Hatha and Raja Yoga practices, where the focus is on the chakras, because that's the gateway through which your consciousness is liberated, and the goal being liberation into a transcendence. In the integral yoga, the goal being transformation, the focus is not on the chakra. The focus is on the entire plane of consciousness corresponding to each chakra. So the actual purification is made on the full plane, not just a center. And the result is the descending movement works to purify and transform plane-wise rather than chakra-wise. And it's much more complete and leads finally to a transformation in a liberated consciousness rather than merely liberation from an unregenerate vehicle.